Advanced. Wait, hold on. It's preparing the live streaming preview, you guys. Let's see if this works. It's 7 o'clock exactly. We're gonna go live. Should I?
Shouldn't you? Yeah, I mean,
all right.
It'll help people.
No, let me go back here.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go live anyway. Sorry. It's next time we'll be live. We're good. It's still 7 o'clock, so we're still on time. Oh, it says we're live now, you guys. I see us. All right. I think this is happening. All right.
Yay!
Well, yay! Yes!
We're live. You did
we're
it.
Live. All right.
Yes, well, we did it.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Woulda, Coulda, Shoulda. This is our new Paradigm Theater showcase for several people who are part of our tribe, and they're in their shows at school, and they were canceled. Or in some cases, it's just a song we like and we want to get a chance to perform. So we decided to get together and put this together, and we're really excited to present this to you tonight. Cameron and I have our NPT shirts, Kristen, just so you notice, and so does Austin. So there you go. So go NPT Youth Board. So I'm very, very excited to introduce everybody tonight. You're going to see us performing one at a time. Just to remind you, you can donate if you'd like to. We are a nonprofit, and we can, someone just texted me. Hi, Kristen. Hello. please donate to our website, nptheater.org, okay? And Kristen, I'm sure we'll post a link as well. So Julia Allen is my beautiful co-host. Hello, Julia.
Beautiful. Hi.
And brilliant and very talented.
Oh, Julia, no, I'm not.
We have known each other for quite a long time. I
yes, know. We have. She was my drama teacher in school.
I was indeed. So I'm very, but Julia is the one who introduced me to NPT. So look at that. Isn't that great? So Julia, who do we have first to perform tonight?
I think we have Paul Litchfield.
I think you're right. I think it's Paul. So Paul, what are you going to sing for us?
I'm going to be singing Girl For Me from Little Shop of Horrors. I was actually Seymour in Little Shop of Horrors for my school play, and like many people, it was canceled. So I also have the plant Audrey too joining me for this song, and I hope you enjoy.
Excellent. So, Paul, we're all gonna stop our videos. I did want to ask Paul, how long did you rehearse your show before it got canceled?
We rehearsed for I think close to 2 months.
Oh my god!
By the time we were about, I think we were less than a month or about a month away from the show going up.
So now you are completely prepared. All right,
yep.
Paul. So now it's out to the world. So we're stopping our video and we.
Aw, Tui, I don't know else to do for you. Now, Mr. Mushtig and Audrey, they just met you, but I've been going through it with you for weeks. Grow and wilt, spurt and flop. Are you a sick little plant, or are you just stubborn? What is it you want? What is it you need? I've given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly, I'm down on my knees. Now please grow for me. I've given you plant food and water to sip. I've given you potash. You've given me zip. Oh God, how I missed you. Oh pod, how you tease. Now please grow for me. I've given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I pinch you back hard, like I'm supposed to, you're barely alive. I've tried you with levels of moisture, from desert to mud. I've given you croites and mineral supplements, what do you want from me, blood? Ow! Damn roses, damn thorns, clumsy me. Hey, Tui, look what I did. Hey, you're opening up. I wonder what made you do that. I think I know what made you do that. Oh, well, I guess a few drops couldn't hurt, as long as you don't make a habit out of it. I've given you sunshine. I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy, unless I open a vein. I'll give you a few drops, if that'll appease. Now please, oh, oh, please, grow for me.
Great.
Bravo.
That was really, really good.
That is beautiful.
Yes. Excellent job, Paul. I'm so sorry you didn't get to do the whole show, but hopefully soon you will be able to do that for a live audience. But that was excellent. So thank you so much. So Julia, who's up next for us?
Anna.
I think we have Anna. So Anna, what are you singing for us?
I'm singing My Husband Makes Movies from the musical Nine.
And tell us why you're singing this song.
So I was cast as Louisa to sing this song in Nine, which was supposed to go up at the beginning of May at my theater school, the Hart School.
And so how much rehearsal time did you actually have for the show?
We had one day. We had one little day right before spring break, and then we went on break, and our school canceled for the rest of the year, so we never got to do anything else.
And I will tell you, Nine is a wonderful show, and it's really rarely done. So you guys are really in for a treat. This is a terrific song. So Anna, we're really excited that you're gonna sing this for us tonight. And hopefully it'll be the preview of an amazing future performance.
Thank you.
My husband makes movies. To make them, he lives a kind of dream in which his actions aren't always what they seem. He may be on to some unique romantic theme. Some men catch fish, some men tie flies, some earn their living baking bread. My husband, he goes a little crazy, making movies instead. My husband spins fantasies. He lives them, then gives them to you all. While he was working on the film on ancient Rome, he made the slave girls take the gladiators home. Some men buy stocks, some men punch clocks, some leap where others fear to tread. My husband is author and director, makes up stories in his head. Guido Contini, Luisa Contini,
Number one genius and number one fan, Guido Contini, Luisa Contini, daughter of well-to-do Florentine clan, long ago, 20 years ago, once the names were Guido Contini, Luisa da Forno, actress with dreams and a life of her own, passionate, wild, and in love in Livorno, singing with Guido all night on the phone, long ago, someone else ago, how he needs me so, and he'll be the last to know it. My husband makes movies. To make them, he makes himself obsessed. He works for weeks on end without a bit of rest. No other way can he achieve his level best. Some men read books, some shine their shoes, some retire early when they've seen the evening news. My husband only rarely comes to bed. My husband makes movies instead. My husband makes movies.
Awesome job.
Thank you.
That was really, really beautiful.
Thank you so much.
That's excellent. All right, who do we have next, Julia?
Oh, it looks like Helen is going to take on the world, pun intended.
Oh, yes, because thanks for setting up that joke, Julia. So Helen, what are you going to sing for us?
I'm going to be singing Take Me to the World from Evening Primrose.
Excellent. Now, was this a show you were planning to do?
No, I was going to do 13 at my middle school, but I decided to sing this song instead because I really enjoy it and I think it's pretty timely for the circumstances.
I think you're absolutely right. Excellent, Helen. All right, so we're all gonna stop our videos and mute our microphones to hear you.
Let me see the world with clouds. Take me to the world. Out where I can push through crowds. Take me to the world. A world that smiles with streets instead of aisles. Let me see the world that's real. Show me how it's done. Teach me how to laugh, to feel. Move me to the sun. Just hold your hand whenever we arrive. Take me to alive. Let me see the world that smiles. Take me to the world. Out where I can walk for miles. Take me to the world. Sound let me see the world come true. We shall have the world. I won't be afraid with you. We shall have the world. Just hold my hand and know I'm not alone. We shall have the world to keep. Such a lovely world. Will we shall have the world forever.
Great job, Helen. That's a great song. Wasn't that great, Julia?
Yes.
Excellent.
Thank you. Here is one of my favorite numbers in this, Cameron and Austin, the parrot scene.
The parrot scene, the Monty Python parrot scene. Austin, are you here? I see you.
Yes. Excellent.
And I'll tell a little bit of backstory about this scene. They were not supposed to perform this, but Cameron was supposed to be in Adam's family at school. And Austin, were you in Once on this Island?
Nope.
All right. Well, if we had more time in our acting class, I was going to have them do this scene. So this is something that should have happened in our acting class. So everyone, you guys stop your videos, please, except for Cameron and Austin.
Hello, I wish to register a complaint. Hello, miss?
What do you mean, miss?
I'm sorry. I have a cold. I wish to complain about this parrot, what I purchased not half an hour ago from this very boutique.
Oh yes, the Noreen Blue. What's wrong with it?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it, my lad. He's dead. That's what's wrong with it.
No. He's resting.
Look, matey, I know a dead parrot when I see one, and I'm looking at one right now.
No. He's not dead. He's resting. Remarkable bird, the Norwegian Blue, isn't it? Beautiful plumage.
The plumage doesn't even set into it. It's stone dead.
No. No, he's resting.
All right, then. If he's resting, I'll wake him up. Hello, Mr. Bolly Barrett. I've got lovely fresh cuttlefish for you if you show.
There. He moved.
No, he didn't. That was you hitting the cage.
No, I didn't.
Hello, Polly. Testing. This is your 9 o'clock alarm call. Now that's what I call a dead parrot.
No. You're stunned. He's stunned.
Stunned?
Yeah, you stunned him. Norwegian Blue stunned easily.
Now look, mate. I have definitely had enough of it. That parrot is definitely deceased. And when I purchased it, not half an hour ago, you assured me that its total lack of movement was due to it being tired following a prolonged squawk.
Norwegian Blue prefers keeping on its back. Lovely plumage. Say.
I took the liberty of examining that parrot when I got it home, and I discovered the only reason it had been sitting on its perch in the first place was that it had been nailed there.
Well, of course it was nailed there. If I hadn't nailed the bird down, it would have nuzzled up to those bars, bent them apart, and went boom.
Boom? Mate, this bird wouldn't boom if you put 4 million volts through it. He's bleem-demised.
No, he's pining.
He's not pining. He's passed on. This parrot is no more. He has ceased to be. He has expired and gone to meet his maker. He's a stiff, bereft of life. He rests in peace. If you had nailed him to the perch, he'd be pushing up the daisy. His metabolic processes are now history. He's off the twig. He's kicked the bucket. He's shuffled off his mortal coil, run down the curtain and joined the bleeding choir invisible. This is an ex-parrot.
Well, I'd better replace it then. Sorry, Squire, I've had a look around the back of the shop, and we're right out of parrots.
I see, I get the picture.
I got a slug.
Pray, does it talk?
Not really.
Well, then it's hardly a bloody replacement, then, is it?
Thanks, you guys.
Great job, you guys.
Nice job. Yes, and I want to show you that I explained this to you guys yesterday, but this, because Amazon doesn't deliver things quickly, this is actually a parrot costume for a cat. And because our cats would not agree to be dressed up as a parrot, we had to use the teddy bear. So you know what? We try to get creative with our props here. So Julia, who do we have next on our showcase?
We have Macy singing I Do, I Do in the Sky.
Excellent. So Macy, tell us, this is from, what show is this from?
This is from The Drowsy Chaperone. I was supposed to be in it. I was supposed to play tricks. So this is the song I would have sung, but I can't, I'm only singing the beginning part because the rest of it needs a bigger ensemble and I don't have that. So I'm just gonna do the beginning.
Now, and also Macy, you're still rehearsing this show, right? Because it hasn't been officially canceled, right?
It hasn't been officially canceled. So we don't really know what's going on, but we are still doing like 2 rehearsals a week.
Great. All right, that's good to know. All right, you guys ready? Everyone stop your video and mute.
A bride and groom in a chapel may bring a tear to the eye, but what a thrill when lovebirds trill, I do in the sky. When vows are said in a meadow, the bees and daffodils sigh, but heartbeats rush when sweethearts gush, I do in the sky. Do you? Do you? Do you? Do you? A bride and groom in a chapel may bring a tear to the eye, with rainbows bending before us and clouds meandering by. One can't restrain that sweet refrain, I do in the sky.
That was great, Macy. That was great. I can't wait to see the rest of it with the full ensemble. That sounded really, really good. Wasn't that great, Julia?
Yes, it was.
Excellent. Who do we
and
have?
You know who else? And you know who else is great?
Who
Olivia.
Else? Well, of course. And what, Olivia, what are you going to sing for us?
I'm going to be singing Disneyland from the musical Smile.
Excellent. Now, was this a song you were supposed to sing in a show?
No, this is not a song I was supposed to sing. I was supposed to be in The Drowsy Chaperone with Macy. But it's just a song that I've learned to really love and perform.
Excellent. That sounds perfect. All right. I can't wait to hear it.
On Sunday night, I guess the folks were busy fighting. Joe'd already left home. 11 years old on my own, feeling nothing but lonely. There's nothing out there but the traffic down on State 93. So I sit through the night player on black and white TV. That's where I saw it. That's when I heard it. Call me.
brushes done with mirrors, the magic there. Each little bird's full of springs, you press a button, it sings recorded music in the air. They've had the mountain replaced, it's only a play, but it pays no one. Say it. I'll turn around and tell you night and day. I will live in Distinti. Make my home in Distinti. Maybe it's a fake. That's a chance I'll take. It's perfectly okay. Someone give me Distinti.
That was excellent. That was great, Olivia. Really, really nice. Right, Julia?
Yes.
So, Julia, who do we have next?
We have Hannah singing The Italian.
Excellent. So, Hannah, tell us about this song.
So, this is the song that I was supposed to sing as Sarahgina in the musical Nine, same production that Anna was supposed to do in May at the Hart School.
Oh, all right then. Well, again, hopefully this is just a preview and you'll get to do this sometime soon.
I hope so.
Live people. Well, not that people aren't live, but we know what I mean. All right. Yeah. So everyone, let's stop our videos and let's listen to Be Italian.
Be Italian. Be Italian, take a chance and try to steal a fiery kiss. Be Italian, you rapscallion, when you hold me, don't just hold me, but hold this. Sentimental, go ahead and try to give my cheek a pat, but be daring and uncaring. If you pinch me, try and pinch me where there's fat. Be a singer, be a lover. Pick the flower now before the chance is past. Be Italian, you rapscallion. Live today as if it may become your last.
Oh, Hannah, that was great. What a great song. I love the music from that show. So again, I hope you guys get to perform it soon. So Julia, I think we just have one more performer, right?
Yes, we do. And that is the lovely, lovely Ajibullah Tajdeen.
Oh yeah, and what else do we call him?
We call him Kimi for short.
Oh, you got my name right, I love that.
So Kimi, tell us what you're going to sing, what it is from, and why you chose that song.
I'll be singing I'll Cover You, the reprise from Rent, and I love this show so much, and actually I was supposed to perform it at my school in March, and we had 7 months of rehearsal, and we got canceled the day before our performance, so yeah.
Well, at least you're well rehearsed.
So yes.
So again, hopefully this is just the beginning. So let's all listen to Kimi.
Live in my house, I'll be your shelter. Just pay me back with 1,000 kisses. Be my lover, and I'll cover you, yeah. Open your door, I'll be your tenant. Don't got much baggage to lay at your feet, but sweet kisses I've got to spend. I'll be there and I'll cover you. Oh, I think they meant it when they said you can buy love. Now I know you can rent it. Ain't no lease, you are my love. Our love, all my life. I've longed to discover something as true as this is. So with a thousand sweet kisses, I'll cover you with a thousand sweet kisses. With a thousand sweet kisses. When your heart has expired, oh, lover, I'll cover you, yeah. Oh, lover, I'll cover you, yeah. Seasons of love.
Oh my God.
Wow. Nice job, Kimi.
You never cease to amaze me.
That was fantastic. And what a wonderful way to end Woulda, Coulda, Shoulda. So you see this amazing talent we have here that didn't get to perform on a stage in front of live people, but we're trying to do everything we can at NPT to support everybody and to really help these guys as much as we can. So again, don't forget to donate, please, at nptheater.org. And if you're just a little too tired tonight, whatever, the weather's too good, you know, you could come to our gala next Sunday. It's a week from tomorrow, and it's a three-parter. We have, it's called Grub Gala in Greece, because CBS so generously decided to do a Greece sing-along instead of the Tony Awards. So at 7 o'clock, come to our Facebook page, and we're gonna have a professional chef show you how to make the perfect hamburger, like they have in Greece, and the perfect chocolate cherry soda, like they talk about in Greece. Buy your ingredients this week. You can find out all the information on our Facebook page and also on our website. So 7 o'clock is the chef, 7:30, you will see the information about NPT. We will be having our online gala. So you can dress up or dress down. It's okay. Either way is fine. Have some good food. And then, and I think it's 8 o'clock or 8:30 is the sing-along with Grease. So it's an entire evening of theater. And we really appreciate you tuning in and supporting NPT's mission. We love you guys. Thank you so much. Julia, what do you want to say to the people out there?
Stay safe, stay happy, and stay positive.
Excellent. Good night, everybody. Love it. All right. Thanks, everyone. Good night.
Bye. Good night.
Bye-bye. Okay, I stopped our live stream and we are good. Thanks, you guys. You did a great job. Thank you so much.
Thank you.